this. Like, when I was, like, in the early 2000s, like, I was new to all of this, and I think I sustained myself from, like, a very high percentage of soy products. So if you looked at my fridge, I had Gimme Lean soy sausage. I had chicken patties. I had all these types of things. In a very subtle way, I was very emotionally imbalanced at that time. Like, someone talks to me in a very authoritative tone. Like, I could be having an argument about the new milkshakes with a child or friend, and they come off in a really authoritative, yo, I would be rattled to the point I almost feel like I'm about to cry. So, and I'm a naturally sensitive person, but, like, it almost took my sensitivity into this whole other level. And it wasn't until, like, people were like, oh, bro, you know, you like soy, you should be really. That's what things started to change.
So the two things that you use when you're making vegan weed is black seeds or chia seeds. My preference is chia seeds. They're much more nutritious and just better, and it tastes better, and I feel better when I eat it. But what you do is you just throw it in the blender, hit blend, dry, put it in the blender dry, and then it turns into a powder. And then all you do is you like scoop out a tablespoon and then you mix it with some water. There's a ratio you can probably look up. Yeah. Maybe a 1-to-2 ratio. You can look it up the exact thing on the internet, but that's equivalent to one egg. So you would use that instead of the egg when you're baking. And this is important because a part of being vegan is being vigilant and turning over and looking at the ingredients. So that's what makes people feel like, what can I eat? Because egg isn't everything. Milk isn't everything. But it's important to know that it doesn't have to be everything, right? So those are some solutions you can use if you're baking to make things stick together, because people use eggs as a binder. Right, and so you can do that just by eating sea vegetables.
Kelp, nori, jiki, wakame,
those is good. Those kind of has a bacony flavor too. It's like salt, it's like sea salt kind of. So those, you know, they have a really great bulk session at the co-op, so you don't have to get a whole thing full of it. It makes it easier at the beginning. You just get as much as you need for a specific recipe, and then you just work your way towards it.
Yeah, I was just excited to share something. From a standpoint of like making food and empowering yourself in the kitchen, you'd be surprised. You could sneak a lot of stuff into your dishes. Like, you know, you might not even be aiming for a fishy flavor, but the sea vegetables are rich in minerals. They're rich in a lot of pretty much mineral elements that we need for a healthy body. You can sneak those things into your recipes. You can make something that is like barbecue, but it can have dose in it, it can have kelp in it.
Just like a nutrition.
Yeah, totally.